yes, you're quite right, he is playing it with only one hand. All the essentials of Chopin's study are there, although he, of course, originally wrote it for two hands. It's one of a whole series of transcriptions of Chopin's studies by Leopold Godowsky. He was a quite fabulously gifted virtuoso pianist. The only reason his name isn't as familiar as that of Horowitz is that he retired from the concert platform due to illness at a relatively early age. Chopin called these pieces studies, and although we listen to them as pure music, he intended them also as exercises in various aspects of piano technique. But piano technique had moved into a new age by the time Godowsky came along. Liszt, Rachmaninoff, Busoni, and Godowsky himself had brought keyboard virtuosity to a new pitch, and Godowsky's transcriptions of Chopin are intended to stretch the pianist to the limits of the possible. They are quite hair-raisingly difficult, and very few pianists have the commanding technique that's necessary simply to play the notes, let alone make those notes effective as music. Jorge Bolet, perhaps because of his friendship many years ago with Godowsky, plays these studies often and with real affection.
The Opus 10, number 7, for example, which the original Chopin... I haven't played that in 15 years. So he makes a complete transformation into a what you might term a, almost a nocturne, so that he takes and he does
frequently he will actually change the key of Chopin's original, well, and in so doing, change it, transform it totally.
Yes, of course, there's a reason for that, because to write something like this nocturne in the key of C major, it just wouldn't sound very well. The key of G flat major is a very, very luscious, very sensuous kind of key, so he did the same thing with the I guess he thought D flat major for the left hand particularly would fit much better.
Now, what about the case in which he has two studies being played together? How does he actually manage to get them to fit together?
Well, what he did is that he has taken the Opus 10 number 11, which is basically a study in arpeggios. So, and then he has taken and used the more or less as a an adornment to the arpeggio study, so that it turns out.
I sense a certain touch of devilry in what he's done to the minute waltz. He's saying to the pianist, you thought it was difficult enough as it is, now you see what I've done to it.
You know, instead of... Thank you. horrendously complicated. I mean, you know, the...
And as if that weren't too difficult, looking at some of Godowsky's transcriptions for the left hand, I will swear that there are passages, they may be momentary, where you are required to hold down rather more notes than you have fingers.
Well, naturally, there are many cases that where you have to, you know, roll a chord. In other words, play 4, 5, 6, 7 notes of a chord all in one big sequence, because naturally you can't strike them all together.
And
but that in this kind of music makes it really very, very attractive, and it fits beautifully.
Looking at these, and particularly listening to these Godowsky transcriptions, I get the impression of a pianist of almost limitless technique. Also a poet who was inspired by Chopin to add his own poetic gloss, you might say.
Yes.
But also I get the impression of a man with a certain sense of humor, writing one day something that he knows is going to drive other pianists crazy. Do you get that? What are they going to make of this?
I agree with you there. Godowsky was really a very wonderful man. You know, I worked all these things with him every time I learned a few of his pieces. I would go up to New York and play them for him. And everyone that heard Godowsky play was impressed with the absolute, complete independence of each finger. He seemed to be able to play 10 notes with each finger of the hand and give each one of those 10 notes exactly the intensity, the color, and the dynamic that he wanted. And that is one of the tremendously difficult things in playing Godowsky's music. I mean, it's hard enough to play the notes, but to play the notes and have it sound like the piece of music that it's supposed to be, that is the real problem.
Thank you. Thank you. Godowsky wrote, "The original Chopin studies remain as intact now as they were before any arrangements of them were ever published. In fact, the author claims that after assiduously studying the present versions, many hidden beauties in the original studies will reveal themselves even to the less observant student."
I don't know exactly how to explain this, but leaving out all the harmonic transitions that Godowsky uses makes the actual kernel of Chopin's idea more interesting and much more remarkable and much more valuable.